By now, you know the name Lev Parnas. You know one of his associates, Igor Fruman. Now, these two men we know are linked to Rudy Giuliani, and they had involvement in what was happening in Ukraine, which is certainly a scandal at the minimum. But there's another name. You may have heard, you may not, but you should know it now. And the name is David Correia. Who's he? Businessman. Indicted in that same complaint as Parnas and Fruman, had nothing to do, as far as we know, with Giuliani. It was about money they gave to campaigns on the western part of the United States that were going on. They've all pleaded not guilty. Correia is facing one count of illegally funneling foreign money into Republican political circles. What we want to know is, where'd the money come from? What was it supposed to be used for? Where else may it have been used? Vicky Ward is here. Exclusive new information about this situation. So, David Correia, why do I care?
Why do you care? Because he's the money guy. He's also, to what you just said, been invisible. Kind of until now, because there was only one count in the indictment against Lev Parnas and Igor Fruman against him. But David Correia, according to texts that I have seen, was involved in using the political operation that Lev Parnas and Igor Fruman were conducting for Rudy Giuliani, the dirt digging in Ukraine. David Correia's job was to commercialize all of that. I have a text that shows him setting up business meetings in Ukraine for a trip that Lev Parnas and Igor Fruman took last winter with David Correia to do dig up dirt on Joe Biden at Rudy Giuliani's request.
So help us understand, how does that work? So they're looking for dirt on Biden. That gives them some cachet because they're working, they're telling people at least, I'm close to Rudy Giuliani, I'm close to the president, I matter.
Exactly.
And what do they use that to do?
Well, they're using that. Their main objective, it would seem from the texts, was to sell, they wanted to try to find a way to sell liquefied natural gas into Ukraine via Poland. That was the main objective. They actually would take meetings with other people too. There was a Libyan scheme as well. But it was all about using their new political contacts for business purposes. So David Correia, if you like, shows us the hidden agenda.
And do we know that, like, who was aware of this and why is it wrong? Do we think, we have no reason to believe Rudy knew what they were doing on the side?
Well, we do. There is a connection, actually, between David Correia and Rudy Giuliani. So I have reported for CNN that this spring, Rudy Giuliani, Lev Parnas and Igor Fruman and the journalist John Solomon, who would propagandize the anti-Biden stuff from the interviews.
A lot of time on Fox,
exactly,
putting out what Rudy
that Lev
told.
Parnas was arranging. They would have these meetings in the Trump Hotel in Washington, in a private room in the BLT restaurant there. What one of the texts shows us is that David Correia had the inside track on what Solomon was going to say. He actually sent a link of one of Solomon's columns to a friend of his and said, it's starting, and the column was headlined, Joe Biden's 2020 Ukraine Nightmare.
So the fact of Correia knowing about the effort to get dirt on the Bidens, that matters?
Right.
Why?
Well, because until now, it seemed that he was somehow separated from this whole geopolitical...
I'm just a businessman.
Sort of, yes.
I don't have anything to do with it.
Right, and he was the only sort of American-born, university-educated. He was the plausible... He was the one who kind of got the meetings. You know, somebody who was in a meeting with Dmytro Firtash, his lawyers. This is Dmytro Firtash, the Ukraine oligarch.
With the connections to Putin.
With the connections to Putin, who is facing extradition to the United States for bribery charges, that his lawyers, took a meeting in Washington, and David Correia gave Lev Parnas and Igor Fruman plausibility because of his sort of appearance, his education, his formality. Interestingly, Dmytro Firtash is the one sort of time when all the business scheming that David Correia was planning that actually paid off to some extent.
All right, so two important boxes to check. One, Correia's got counsel. Obviously, he's dealing with this. What is his response to the idea that he was connected more to this political part than before understood?
Well, his lawyers are not commenting to any of the allegations. We've put them, they're not commenting on any of the text messages. Mm. He obviously pled not guilty along with the others. I think what's super interesting is that he sent a text in October, right around the time that the whistleblower, the reports were all coming out, that he was in Dubai. He told two sources he was in Dubai to close a deal with Dmytro Firtash. In his text messages, he says that the phone starts to ring and ring. It becomes extremely stressful for him. And as we know, 2 days later, Lev Parnas, Igor Fruman were indicted, as was he. He came back to JFK and turned himself in.
Now, the big issue becomes, what is his connection to Firtash in terms of the money that was trickling down to Fruman and to Parnas? And did any of it go to Rudy? And did Rudy know its sourcing? So that part of the story continues.
Yet to come.
And you have been our guide all along the way. Vicky Ward, thank you very much.